here we go for the bantamweight title, the armbar specialist versus the grinder, and Stolyarenko coming out like it's a one-round fight. Very aggressive.
Very aggressive, Jimmy. And she has a lot of first-round finishes. She definitely has a...
Oh, nice high kick. That caught her, and another one caught her. Oh, but she runs into a right hand. Back and forth, and she will pull guard, looking for that armbar. Cutting the angle, she's almost got it. Verzosa able to circle out just in time.
Beautiful hammer fist there.
Wow.
What an incredibly fast.
Do they think they're in the tournament? It's a one-round fight? No, this is a five-rounder. And they're fighting like it's a one-rounder.
They really are. And traditionally, Stolyarenko is an incredibly fast starter. She is very, very aggressive with how she starts her fights.
Man, that head kick right on the money. See Verzosa blinking another good right hand. Verzosa eating a lot of not just kicks, but punches as well. And Stolyarenko going down for that armbar. This time, Verzosa not going to the ground with her.
And that is what is so gangster about Stolyarenko, is she will pull guard. She will jump guard in the middle of a fight, looking for that armbar because she is so confident.
Do you believe once she goes to the ground, she can get it? She's doing a great job with the strikes. It was Verzosa who initiated the clinch. Head kick combo and the right hand over the top. Stolyarenko had her rocked. I believe she is still wobbly, Megan.
She really is, but you know, Verzosa does have a little bit of an awkward, unorthodox style with her striking. She does have a tendency to be a little bit flat-footed, but she is very, very powerful when she does land.
She moves generally very, very well, but her head very stationary in this fight. That's why that overhand right has been so effective for Stolyarenko.
She's doing a good job of bringing her head off the center line as they trade that right hand. So it's landing on Verzosa, but it isn't landing on Stolyarenko.
Stolyarenko committing to every single strike, be it the kick or the punch over the top. Verzosa hasn't been able to find her own offense yet. Could be biding her time, trying to drag this into the later rounds. One thing about being a finisher, if you can get him out of round one, they slow down quite a bit. Could be what Verzosa is counting on.
It's really interesting to see because we're about 3 minutes into this fight now, and I feel like Stolyarenko and Verzosa are really settling into the fight now. It's not as crazy. It's, oh man.
And just as you say that, she lands a head kick over the top. Another right hand rocks her.
The toughness of Lisa Verzosa.
But she's got to get out of the way of these brutal punches. She has been a sitting duck, now rolling for the armbar again.
My goodness. She is just so creative with her transitions, and she will throw up an armbar from anywhere.
No fear at all. Trying to extend her body. If she can get her flipped over, she can finish this. So far, Verzosa able to stay on top. She's holding on to that grip for dear life. Because if Stolyarenko can get it extended, this might be over. She's got it twisted. Now it's a shoulder lock.
That does not look pleasant.
Yeah, it's like an Americana from armbar position. Now she has that arm extended and able to turn it out again.
Goodness.
Now the old school fans, Kazushi Sakuraba got a move like this, and a guy named Ebenezer Fontes Braga turned an armbar into an Americana, able to twist the shoulder. He got the tap. It can be done. I know that's Sakuraba, but it can be done. Stolyarenko has to let it go.
And she's doing a beautiful job. She's already looking to rotate her hips. And Verzosa is doing a good job of trying to stay square. But Stolyarenko is putting her feet on the hips, and that enables her to swivel with such intensity.
That's how you isolate the arm, is getting your hips off the center line. But Verzosa, for the beating she has taken, we'll see the end of round one. some blood out of the nose of Stolyarenko. She took some damage, she walked into some punches, but it's been Verzosa who's been on the receiving end of most of the stand-up damage. She's had to fight off a few armbar attempts. I am very interested to see if this is a 10-9 or a 10-8 round. I'm almost sure it's for Stolyarenko. You have to be blind to do it, say anything else.
I think that looks like a 10-9 to Stolyarenko.
Yeah, I think it's 10-9 all the way down to Stolyarenko. I think that's the right call. Could have gone 10-8. It was quite dominant. Look at that head kick over the top. She had a rock more than once, Megan.
She really did, but I think with Stolyarenko, she initiates with such force that she is able to get countered herself.
We didn't have the audio for it, but I am telling you. See there, 10-9 all the way across the board for Stolyarenko. If you're Verzosa's corner, what you tell her is the worst is over. She's most powerful in round one. It's all downhill from here. Whether or not it's the truth, who cares? But that's what you tell your fighter.
Yeah, and the thing is that you have to really get them out of that mentality of the first round. It's like, look, we're settled in the fight. We're not going to be as fast twitch. We're not going to be as explosive. Now it's our time to get to work.
And none of the judges went 10-8 in round one. She's not in a, doesn't have a terrible deficit in front of her. She has a good round. Right back to even. That's what you think if you're Lisa Verzosa. And how much energy did Yulia Stolyarenko use in that first round? That is a huge question.
It definitely looks like she's breathing heavier coming into this round, but also she's bleeding from her nose, so how much is that to do with not being able to breathe out of her nose? I don't know, but she does seem to have slowed down a little bit.
Oh, nice right hand by Verzosa. Good counter catching Stolyarenko coming in.
Beautiful uppercut there.
It's interesting for such a great armbar, which she does have, we haven't seen any real takedown attempts. It's been guard pulls. She hasn't really tried to clinch or trip or commit to any leg takedowns.
No, she really doesn't. And she kind of throws those armbar attempts from nowhere. And it's very hard to train that.
Not exactly of the position before submission school. That doesn't seem to be her thing.
No, definitely isn't. But that's what makes it so exciting.
Certainly fun to watch. Oh, nice right hand by Stolyarenko.
She's just doing such a good job of timing that right hand from Verzosa and trading, but making sure she brings her head off the center line. Beautiful right hand again there.
Wouldn't surprise me if that left eye starts closing up on Verzosa.
Beautiful lead leg.
Good job by Verzosa keeping that right hand up. Good counter leg kick. Briefly took Stolyarenko off balance. That's what allowed the right hand to slip in. It's like Stolyarenko could close her eyes and throw the right hand and it would land. Verzosa coming in the same way at the same angle every time.
Yeah, and Stolyarenko just seems to be the faster of the two with her striking. Verzosa seems to be, you know, a little bit slower with the timing. And like you said, she's not really coming in at any different angles. So Stolyarenko knows exactly where she's going to be. She's not really giving her a different read.
I had a striking coach tell me one time, two fighters set a rhythm, the one who breaks the rhythm wins. The one who changes something up is the one who has the advantage.
I 100% agree with you.
So far, Verzosa coming in with the same offense every time, and Stolyarenko so far has it read. And probably because of that armbar skill, no takedown attempts so far from Verzosa.
Nice right hand for Verzosa.
Good timing on that one. Usually a fighter who's losing the stand-up battle will at least change it up, attempt a takedown. None of that from Verzosa.
Yeah, and I think the danger factor that Stolyarenko poses on the ground could be a big factor for that. Why risk going into Stolyarenko's world?
And there's the first commitment to Dana. She rolls right for the armbar. Briefly in double leg position. Now going Imanari roll. It's a gutsy move in an MMA fight.
Well, when you're a Burmese bare-knuckle boxing champion.
I mean, you're not worried about getting punched.
Why not?
Yeah, why not?
Beautiful head kick there, returned by Verzosa.
Have you seen those Burmese fights?
They are brutal.
They are brutal. There's some, they allow headbutts and everything. It is crazy.
Good.
Check it out if you can. We will see the end of round two. Lisa Verzosa versus Yulia Stolyarenko for the title.
Very intrigued how they scored that round.
And the cool thing is we'll find out right now.
I know.
I mean, it's so awesome.
I'm so excited.
Everything she has, right?
There's the commissioner behind the corner. Remember, first round across the board, 10-9 Stolyarenko. And it is 10-9 for Zosa this time.
And that is what makes this so intriguing now.
Yep.
We are an even
19,
apiece.
All tied up. And Verzosa knows it. What a shot in the arm that is as a fighter. A horrible first round, but I got back. We are now even. You can see it in her face. She is energized knowing that.
You really can, Jimmy. She looks super focused. And I think, I wonder if Stolyarenko, how does she change her game plan now?
Thought she landed some brutal right hands in rounds one and two. Not as close with the armbar attempts, but will she change things up on the feet? Will she commit a bit more to the takedown? If you know the score, it allows you to evolve your game plan a bit. You know it's not working. Has to change things up. Does she have the toolkit to do that?
Big right hand from Verzosa. I would like to see her feint a little bit more as she enters into that pocket. Draw those counters out.
Because they've been big. Stolyarenko has committed to every punch. They aren't, you know, range-finding kind of punches. They're big, solid right hands. When you get someone to throw that and miss, takes a lot out of them. Good right hand by Verzosa. She's starting to kind of read the timing of Stolyarenko. And Stolyarenko, you said, had the speed advantage, slowing down a little bit now. Good sequence of punches, backs up Verzosa. Stolyarenko going back to committing to the right hand.
I think Verzosa is doing a really good job of using that lead side uppercut as Stolyarenko enters into the pocket. It creates a different angle. It's a punch that she can't see coming.
That blood really starting to flow out of the nose of Stolyarenko. They're like two rams fighting over some territory. They seem to attack at the exact same time, leading with their heads, really committing to the right hand.
Big stiff jab by Verzosa, though. And I was literally thinking the same thing, Jimmy. It's like we have a lot of movement on the outside, and then they both throw with everything right at the same time, and then they're back circling. And I really feel like one of these fighters needs to continue and not reestablish that range. Keep on of that pressure and really start stacking up those forward momentum, that constant combinations, and that's what breaks fighters.
That's been a consistent theme tonight, hasn't it, Megan?
It really
has. We'll see a great right hand. We'll see a great jab. We saw in the Guardado fight is that she had a good power shot, but not the three or four, the five that'll back an opponent up, that will take them by surprise, that will get them physically moving backward, that will give you the real estate. It's all about the long combinations. The one who throws that is usually successful.
I 100% agree, Jimmy. And if you look at the face of Stella Yarenko, she is... has a lot of damage on her face. So I feel like in these moments right here, Verzosa needs to commit. She needs to continue going forward, because whoever starts landing consistently first and backing up their opponent tends to be winning.
Oh, good right hand again by Verzosa. Another one. Stolyarenko firing back. You might wonder, also, for Stolyarenko, she has hit Verzosa with clean right hands, especially in round one, plenty in round two, plenty in round three, and she hasn't really, her face is swelling up, but she hasn't really been able to really get Verzosa on her heels or moving back. Oh, nice cut on the bridge of her nose. Just as I said that, she may have really hurt her.
That could have been that she ended with a beautiful lead side elbow.
Yeah, it sliced her up good. Another good elbow.
Beautiful.
That cut is bad. Very bad. Verzosa needs to turn it up now, because they check that cut, this fight might be over.
See, the good thing is it's right in the middle of her forehead, so it's draining right down the straight of her nose and not going into her eyes, which could be beneficial.
So maybe she,
even though not getting cut,
right,
is probably better.
Not getting cut all is more beneficial.
That is pouring blood now.
They both look like extras on The Walking Dead. That shows you a little bit how this fight is going and how much action there has been from beginning to now. We're only in round three.
That lead side elbow is just doing so much damage. Look at the blood on her elbow.
Stolyarenko has found a target for that elbow. The doctor is coming in. It wouldn't surprise me if this is the last round of this fight.
Oh, man. Her mouth keeps coming out.
It looks like a faucet of blood on her forehead. That cut looks nasty from here. Stolyarenko doesn't look great, but she's not cut. All that blood is coming out of the nose. Doctor is looking at Stolyarenko.
Beautiful right hand there by Verzosa. And once she starts getting her timing and she starts committing and moving forward, she's having a lot of success. Beautiful elbow there. And I think that lead elbow has been such a key for Stolyarenko, particularly in this round.
The doctor is now looking at the cut. He is not stopping the fight. We are gonna see a round four, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, man.
Wow. That looks like she got hit with an axe.
And she's still smiling.
And she's still happy about it, Negan. She's still thrilled. I gotta say, I'm thrilled that we're in round four. This has been a great fight. Stolyarenko ahead on two cards. Verzosa ahead on one. But now, Stolyarenko has a target. And the target is going to be that cut right in between the eyes. She's committing to every punch. It is now open and bleeding.
That jab is landing beautiful. It's snapping Verzosa's head back every time she lands.
And every time she lands it, there is literally a spray of blood. And if you don't think that's going into both eyes, you're wrong. This might be the bloodiest fight I've seen in Invicta. And I mean both fighters.
It's been absolutely incredible.
It's been a war.
This has been a fans' fight. Blood from the first round. You couldn't ask for anything more in a title fight.
Both fighters trading power punches. It's been back and forth. I put Stolyarenko ahead in the last round. Two of the judges agree with me. Remember, fans, we're trying the open scoring for the first time. Therefore, we know we are not guessing. Two judges have Stolyarenko ahead, 2-1. Going into this fourth round, it has been back and forth. Verzosa coming back in round two, but in round three, a horrible cut right between the eyes from a lead elbow. We talked about changing the distance, changing the pattern, changing the range. The elbow does that. Instead of a right hand, there's a shorter weapon coming at you from a different angle, and Verzosa just didn't see it coming. Maybe.
She really didn't, and Stolyarenko has opened up two cuts, one just below the eye and one over the forehead, and that beautiful jumping elbow there. And that has been the distance, as you said, closing that range and not letting Verzosa use those long range punches, because once she did and she started landing consistently those long jabs and crosses, she was having a lot more success.
Stolyarenko, her skin looks like she went to a tanning salon and went, blood, go for the blood look, because it is all over the front of her body.
And if you look at the mat,
bad move by Stolyarenko. It's the second time she's done that. Her mouthpiece has come out. She bent down to get it. Verzosa could have attacked. The referee did not say stop or break. Got to be very conscious of that. The referee doesn't say stop. Your opponent can hit you. Now, Verzosa, being a sportsman,
man,
she didn't have to.
That cut is absolutely leaking now. And it looks like she has a cut over her left ear as well. It looks like there's blood coming from just on top of that left ear.
I think you are right.
You know, and probably from those now backside elbows. Man, Stolyarenko is really adjusting to the range and really finding a way to disrupt the timing and change it up.
Right when it looked like Verzosa had her time a little bit in round two, it's like she was figuring her out. She was starting to land effective punches. And it's really hard moving to not stand up and yell, stop doing that. If I was her corner, that's the worst thing you can do.
Yeah.
All Verzosa has to do is throw a kick in that situation. She knows her head's going to go down. Can't do that unless the referee says break. Those coaching instincts when they come back.
But it is difficult, particularly for Verzosa, as she tries to initiate and then your opponent, and so she's being a respectful fighter, and then your opponent is just bending down to pick up the mouth guard when the referee hasn't said stop. In the Gordano fight, they let it run until the action stopped. So that is up to the ref. So I feel like Stolyarenko definitely should not be doing that. And it should be up to the referee.
Yep. That time she came in with an elbow and got clipped with a left hook. Caught her off balance. Look at the mat. That is all from one fight. Dan and Nap, big dry cleaning bill after this is over. Wow.
Oh my goodness.
Once again, the doctor's gonna come in between rounds, and will we get a final round? My broadcast partner, Megan Anderson, making a few gagging faces. That's okay, it's gonna be all right. It's a bloody fight, but we're gonna get through it together.
I just worry about interviewing them afterwards and being covered in their blood.
All right, well, this dress, just kiss it goodbye. I'm just gonna say that to you right now. I am glad you're doing the interviews and not me. Faith Van Duen is speaking for all of us. Respect to these two beasts. Get at us. Phoenix Series 3. This has been an amazing fight. Looks like the blue corner is ahead on two scorecards.
Guys, let's go. Come on, guys.
We are going to get a fifth and final round out of these two warriors. This crowd really appreciating this fight. So should the fans at home. It's been an absolute war. That's the only way I can describe it. Battle just doesn't do it justice. You see the scores are kind of all over the board. Stolyarenko ahead on two judges' scorecards.
And that's what makes this open scoring so beneficial, because now we are in the championship round and it is, we leave it up to the fighters to do the work that they need to do.
Exactly. There's no mystery, they don't have to wonder. Rososa is putting everything into every punch. She knows she has to get a finish here. Stolyarenko, I don't see her taking her foot off the gas at all. That's just not how she's wired. But if Shannon Knapp books a rematch between these two fighters, we're gonna have to call a blood bank, because this has been one of the most grueling fights I have ever seen in the women's 135-pound division.
I agree with you.
Stolyarenko is covered in Verzosa's blood.
Her hair has changed color.
It's red. It's red.
Now red.
It's looked like she's been in a tanning bed full of blood.
She really has. And Verzosa, though, is doing a very good job. She's pressuring a lot heavier in this round, knowing that she is down two rounds and she needs to get the win.
That's part of the scorecard of the open scoring. She knows she's behind. There's no mystery to it. Stolyarenko still trying to land that big right hand over the top. She ate a left hook last time, coming in with the elbow, so she's been a bit more hesitant to throw it in this fifth round.
Beautiful job.
This is one of those, so you want to be a fighter type fights. This is what you show to somebody coming up who wants to be a mixed martial artist. You show them a fight like this and go, you can win, you can be a champion. But there are moments and rounds and fights like this where every jab meets an ocean of blood coming down your face. That's the price a champion has to pay. Did you just hold up a piece of paper so you don't get sprayed with blood? She just did that. My broadcast partner, Megan Anderson, who, by the way, has done a phenomenal job tonight, just held up a piece of paper to not get sprayed by blood, and I appreciate that. You got a nice dress on. You do. That would suck to get blood on.
Man, both of these ladies showing tremendous heart. The blood that is leaking from Verzosa's face, every time she gets hit, it is spraying everywhere. But she is so tough, and she continues to march forward, and she is landing that right hand so well.
She hasn't taken a backward step. The cut has not mattered. The beating she has taken from the right hand of Stolyarenko has not mattered. She has been in it to win it from the beginning.
You couldn't ask for a better title fight. We've seen everything. We've seen blood. We've seen people get rocked. We've seen tremendous heart. And both of these ladies are absolute gangsters.
Absolutely incredible. One of the best Invicta fights I have ever seen. Stolyarenko once again trying with that lead elbow. Verzosa coming forward, but in my opinion, it was Stolyarenko who made the adjustments at the right time to open up that cut. She changed up her offense, going from the punch to the elbow. It's Verzosa now in the final round of a championship fight who has to make the big adjustment and get something done. She needs a big round or a finish.
She really does, but I think Stolyarenko, it does not look good on the scorecards bit that she is backing up. And with a fight that is pretty close, we have it 2-1 based on the judges, it could flip the other way.
Oh my God, what a big shot. Stolyarenko attacking Verzosa as she's coming in, but Verzosa not backing down. 24 seconds left. The fans here standing up in appreciation. There are fights, there are battles, and there are bloody wars. This is one of the bloodiest wars I have ever seen in my commentating career. Hats off to both of these ladies, and it will go the distance for the bantamweight title. You have to give it up right now for Yulia Stolyarenko versus Lisa Verzosa. Both. On Lisa Verzosa. I am not kidding when I've seen fights stop for way less than I saw in this fight. The doctor looked at the cuts in between every round after it happened, of course. Said she was able to continue. The major cut occurred in round three. Actually, they're both major cuts, but the one in between the eyes happened in round three. We have a decision for our bantamweight title. Here is Joe Martinez.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after five exciting rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. You're already doing it, Kansas. One more time, give it up for both of these fighters inside the cage. Kevin Champion scores it 49-46. Verzosa. Greg DeVilbiss, 48-46 for Stolyarenko. And Judge Stephen Graham scores at 49-46 for your winner by split decision. And now the Invicta FC bantamweight champion of the world from Kaunas, Lithuania, Yulia Stolyarenko.
And there is our very emotional champion First Lithuanian to be a world champion, Yulia Stolyarenko.